We're going to connect the dots for anybody who has ears to hear. Some people are going to want to dispute this, but we're not going to argue with anyone. This is what's going on. There is no Q, there is no anonymous that has any information about this government or anything else that's going on. They have been leading you down a path of lies, all to hide the truth. And here's what's really going on. FEMA has more power than the President of the United States or the Congress. It has the power to suspend laws, move entire populations, arrest and detain citizens without a warrant, and hold them without trial. It can seize property, food supplies, transportation systems, and can suspend the Constitution. When a state of emergency is declared, Executive Order 11921 allows the Federal Emergency Preparedness Agency to develop plans to establish control over the mechanisms of production and distribution of energy sources, wages, salaries, credit, and the flow of money in the U.S. financial institution in any undefined national emergency. It also provides that when a state of emergency is declared by the president, Congress cannot review this action for 6 months. Now, with the understanding that after Trump signed the National Emergency Declaration, FEMA took over. Now, this is March 13th, 2020. Listen to what he's going to say now. This is right after he signed the National Emergency into effect.
It is only the beginning of what we're really doing, and now we're in a different phase.
This is only the beginning of what we're really doing, because what they're really doing is putting everything in place to start the New World Order.
Now we're in a different phase.
The different phase that he's speaking of is that he is no longer president and he has given full power over to FEMA when he signed the National Emergency Declaration.
We had some very old and obsolete rules. Old and obsolete rules.
Those old and obsolete rules are also known as the Constitution of the United States.
That we had to live with. It worked under certain circumstances, but not under mass circumstances. But not under mass circumstances.
Under mass circumstances is being under FEMA rule.
They were there for a long time. They were in place for a long time, and we're breaking them down now. We're breaking them down now.
They're definitely breaking them down because the Constitution is suspended.
And they're very usable for certain instances, but not for this. Not for this.
Because they can't go forward with their plan with the Constitution, our constitutional rights, still intact.
To unleash the full power of the federal government. To unleash the full power of the federal government in this effort today, I am officially declaring a national emergency. I am officially declaring a national emergency.
So he is officially telling us in a coded message that we are now under the rule of FEMA, no longer having a president. Fast forward to March 19th, 2020, in the FEMA National Response Coordination Center.
Well, Mr. President, Vice President, thank you for being here. Really appreciate your visit to FEMA. I think your visit really, as you indicated last week, by signing the national emergency, has really empowered FEMA.
And he just made the declaration that FEMA is empowered, has really empowered FEMA. Fast forward to April 10th, 2020, in plain words, it's been my great honor to have been their president. Past tense.
The American people have been so disciplined. It's been my honor to be their president. I've said it before, I'll say it again, I'll say it always. It's been my great honor to have been their president, and it's been my great honor to have been their president, and have been their president, have been their president. I have a big decision coming up, and I only hope to God that it's the right decision. But it'll be based on the input from a lot of very talented people, very smart people, and people that love our country. Thank you all very much. Thank you. Thank you.
He actually will not be making any more decisions. This group of people that he says will be helping him make decisions are the ones that are making decisions now, because it is FEMA that is making the decisions. And as you can hear in this live briefing, Trump obviously does not know what's going on, because he said, you should have let us know when Mike Pompeo said, we're in a live exercise, a live exercise.
Pompeo says this is a live exercise. And what you'll hear in the background is Donald Trump say, you should have let us know.
This is not about retribution. this matters going forward. We're in a live exercise here to get this right. We need to make sure that even we're in a live exercise here to get this right. We're in a live exercise here to get this right. We're in a live exercise here to get this right.
Does he sound like a man that's in control of anything anymore? He just looks like he has just lost his best friend in all of these videos that we're seeing now ever since he signed the National Emergency Declaration. I'm sure most of us thought that FEMA was created to help people in disasters. But here's the truth about FEMA. FEMA was created in a series of executive orders. A presidential executive order, whether constitutional or not, becomes law simply by its publication in the Federal Registry. Congress is bypassed. Executive Order 12148 created the Federal Emergency Management Agency, that is to interface with the Department of Defense for civil defense, planning, and funding. An emergency czar was appointed. Executive Order 12656 appointed the National Security Council as the principal body that should consider emergency powers. This allows the government to increase domestic intelligence and surveillance of U.S. citizens and would restrict the freedom of movement within the United States and grant the government the right to isolate large groups of civilians. That's where we're at right now, people. We are all being told what to do, where we can and can't go. The National Guard could be federalized to seal all borders and take control of U.S. airspace and all ports of entry. Executive Order 10990 allows the government to take over all modes of transportation and control of highways and seaports. Executive Order 10995 allows the government to seize and control the communications media. Executive Order 10997 allows the government to take over all electrical power, gas, petroleum, fuels, and minerals. Executive Order 10998 allows the government to take over all food resources and farms. Executive Order 11000 allows the government to mobilize civilians into work brigades under government supervision. Executive Order 11001 allows the government to take over all health, education, and welfare functions. Executive Order 11002 designates the Postmaster General to operate a national registration of all persons. That's where your census comes in. Executive Order 11003 allows the government to take over all airports and aircraft, including commercial aircraft. Executive Order 11004 allows the Housing and Finance Authority to relocate communities, build new housing with public funds, designate areas to be abandoned, and establish new locations for populations. Executive Order 11005 allows the government to take over railroads, inland waterways, and public storage facilities. Executive Order 11051 specifies the responsibility of the Office of Emergency Planning and gives authorization to put all executive orders into effect in times of increased international tensions and economic or financial crisis. Executive Order 11310 grants authority to the Department of Justice to enforce the plans set out in executive orders to institute industrial support, to establish judicial and legislative liaison, to control all aliens, to operate penal and correctional institutions. And Executive Order 11049 assigns emergency preparedness function to federal departments and agencies, consolidating 21 operative executive orders issued over a 15-year period.
We are Americans, part of something larger than ourselves. For two centuries, we've done the hard work of freedom, and tonight we lead the world in facing down a threat to decency and humanity. What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order, where diverse nations are drawn together in common cause to achieve the universal aspirations of mankind: peace and security, freedom, and the rule of law. Such is a world worthy of our struggle and worthy of our children's future. We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
Hopefully this has opened some of your eyes so that you can see where we're at in this timeline. This is true. This is what's going on. These are facts. Y'all have a blessed day.